Welcome, everybody. My name is Zohri Chaudhry, and today we'll talk about biological contaminants in water. So what biological organisms contaminate water? There are mostly four different types of organisms, and they are bacteria, protozoa, viruses, helminths, or other parasites. Viruses and bacteria are pretty well known. Viruses are non-cellular, effectively inactivated by chlorine as it applies to the water quality scenario. And because they're really, really small, in order to remove them, it's relatively difficult. And in typical filtration mechanism, they're not filtered well. Diseases that are water-related are gastroenteritis, hepatitis A and E, as well as polio, which are all virus-related diseases, virus-caused diseases related to water. On the other hand, bacteria are prokaryotic organisms, effectively inactivated by adding chlorine in the water. And because of its size, about 1 micrometer in size, it is filterable using common filters in water treatment. Diseases that are caused by bacteria are gastroenteritis or diarrhea, typhoid fever, and cholera. The next set of organisms are protozoas and helminths or parasitic worms. So protozoas have a life cycle that they must spend a small part of their life cycle in an animal host. And by doing that, they complete their life cycle and they exist in the intestines of this animal host. And they get released to the excrement and they go into the environment. They're relatively large, approximately 10 micrometer in diameter, and as a result, easily filterable. Of course, when you add chlorine, protozoas do get inactivated. However, the cyst form, which is a highly resistant form, can resist chlorination. And essentially, once the environment becomes more suitable, the cyst can be transformed into the active protozoa form. Example of diseases that are caused by protozoa are cryptosporidiosis, amoebiasis, as well as giardiasis. Parasitic worms or helminths, as the name implies, they are a parasite. They live inside their host and feed off living host while disrupting the host nutrient absorption capability, causing weakness and disease. So they don't kill the host, because if they were to kill the host, they would have to find a new host every time. So they actually weaken the host and make the host as their home. The parasitic worms are relatively big, so they can be filtered and they are inactivated by chlorine. Diseases caused by parasitic worms are tapeworm diseases, roundworm diseases, as well as guinea worm disease. So, quick classification of water-related infection. So, water infection can happen whether it is waterborne or water washed or water scarce, or water-based, as well as water-related insect factor-related diseases. So four different classification of water-related infections. The waterborne type of diseases, typically the pathogen is in the water that is ingested, and example of diseases would be hepatitis A or cholera. On the other hand, water-washed or water-scarce diseases would happen when person-to-person transmission happens because of a lack of water for hygiene. An example would be giardiasis. A third classification of water-related infection is water-based diseases, and typically the transmission via an aquatic intermediate host, such as guinea worm disease. Water-related insect vector diseases, they happen when transmission by insects that breed in water or bite near water come in contact with human. In this case, malaria or yellow fever are a good example. And this table provides a table where you can look at the various kind of diseases that are water related. In this column, you have some of the major diseases that are virus caused. In here, bacteria, in here, protozoa, and in here, parasites or worms. To give some examples, gastroenteritis caused by norovirus, gastroenteritis caused by rotavirus, as well as hepatitis A caused by hep A virus and hepatitis E caused by hep E virus. They are all virus-related, water-related diseases. Bacteria-caused diseases that are water-related are cholera, typhoid, salmonellosis, gastroenteritis, shigellosis, campylobacteriosis, tularemia as well as legionellosis, and in parentheses you can see the specific bacteria that causes the disease. Protozoa, some examples are giardiasis, cryptosporidiasis, amoebiasis, as well as toxoplasmosis. And then from the parasitic worms, we already covered a few, such as dracunculiasis, or also known as guinea worm disease, schistosomiasis, malaria, onchocerciasis, ascariasis, or roundworm disease, and then the tapeworm disease, or tenesiasis. Okay, so that concludes the lecture. So let's do some quick concept check. Which of the following microorganism is effectively inactivated by adding chlorine in the water? That's correct. All of the above, viruses, bacteria, and protozoas, they're all effectively inactivated by chlorine. So the answer is D. Which of the following water-related disease is caused by a parasite? D, schistosomiasis. Very good. Viruses can typically be filtered during water treatment process. False. That's all.